Our research question, obviously, is how can police academies be reformed to prevent future cases of police brutality in America? The lenses that we thought best fit our topic was ethical, social, future, and historical. Some alarming stats that we found when doing research that in 2016 alone, over 309 Black African Americans were killed by police officers. And I just want to point out, they were all completely unarmed. They did not do anything to arouse the police. They didn't suspect anything. It was all, yeah. Black Americans are 3 times more likely to be killed in America than white people. I know this seems like a lot of racial inequality, but I'll make a connection soon. So another piece of context is I was doing this research. Trainees at the academy are under a lot of stress, and it's not something that you would ever imagine that they would be under. But for one example of it is this tardy policy that they have in place. If a recruit is late to class one time, they are evicted from the program completely, and there's no way for them to come back in and get their spot back. Another thing is we found out that in a 24-week period that these officers are training, only 3 hours of that time is spent on ethics training. So finding out how to de-escalate a situation, talk to someone who speaks another language, like trying to figure out what's the problem, they're only spending 3 hours of a 24-week period learning how to do this. So we all came to the conclusion that we don't think they're getting the proper training that they need, and it's almost like their rights are being infringed upon.
So historically, we have found that police have always used violent behavior and unnecessary force to deal with African-American culprits and criminals that could be doing something wrong. Because between the years 1875 and 1920, 307 people were killed, which accounted for one of every 18 homicides by police officers. And historically also, famous people and athletes have always been racially profiled and suffer from police brutality, even though people know who they are. And this issue has been so bad and predominantly big that it took its way into today.
So our thesis statement is implementing better ethics training and the use of body cameras, it would help reform police academies and other standards that are in place to prevent future cases of police academy. And so we thought about changing the way that they're taught in the academy, and then we also thought about trying to change the way they are in the field.
All right, so the first solution is body-worn cameras. So this chart, basically, in 2014, an experiment was designed to closely observe two different districts in Denver and compare those same two districts 6 months later. So 911 calls in District 1, in the first 3 months, they had 99,647 calls. District 2 having 102,514 calls. After the implementation of body-worn cameras, they had 56,471 calls and 60,650 calls. Then later with the rest, in the first 3 months, again having 1,690 in District 1, 1,598 in District 2, and then after implementing body-worn cameras, in District 1 they had 854, in District 2 they had 782.
So as you can see, once they implemented these body-worn cameras, the arrest started going down, and so we were seeing kind of a correlation there that was almost like the police officers were arresting less people because now they were being taped.
So the limitations of this is that police officers can just take the cameras off. It's also very costly to put a camera on each police officer in an academy, plus all sorts of academies. And lastly, cameras don't follow the eyes, so if one police officer is looking one way, the camera may be recording the complete other thing. So
the solution we are in favor for is increasing the amount of ethics training in American police academies. We think that, obviously from research, that the lacking amount of ethics training has definitely had a direct correlation with the amount of police brutality and racial profiling in America. The only limitation that we can really find with this solution is the fact that they would have to decrease other aspects of the training process, whether that be combat training, ethics, and other important things that they learn at the police academy. Any implication that we would find would be the fact that they would have to agree on a standard or curriculum that they would teach at the police academies, and to make sure that all the law would be enforced equally across America by all officers at any level.
Yay! Sorry I didn't hold the sign up for you, but you're right at 6 minutes, so you're right in the middle of it. So give me just a second to tally this up and I'll ask you your oral defense questions. Did you get pictures?
No, I'll just come back tomorrow.
Okay, guys, anybody want to go first? Diego, you want to go first? Can you describe how the content of the team's presentation was changed as a result of group discussion?
Let's see. Well, at first, it was mostly about just, we were trying to find, like, many different solutions, and then we kind of just stuck to these two.
Okay, anybody want to go next? Piper? In what way did you improve your ability to work with a group as a result of this project, especially since one of your members is missing today?
Well, we were all talking about this actually back there. We all came together and we were talking about how we think we work very well under a stressful environment, trying to figure out who was going to take on which part. Another part, just for me personally, is I tend to take the leadership role, and in this group I kind of gave it up a little bit, and I almost regret that a little bit, but I think we all came together pretty well.
Thank you. And Aiden, how did the group decide to include Miyoko's lens into the overall presentation?
Well, since a lot of her her social lens was very important because we were able to see how people would react to other sides of the argument, and we could see how people in different areas of the country would take their stance on the topic.
All right, thank you. Yay!